Buenos días, good morning, bonjour, guten morgen. ongi etorria Gernikako Bakearen Museora. Plazer bat da guretzako gaur zuek gurekin hemen egotea. Eta, bueno, arte memoria eta espazio publikoaren gaia asko interesatzen zaigu aspalditik. Eta horrekin hasiko gara. Gitzi garen ez, saiatuko gara moldatzen pizka bat hizkuntzen aldetik. Buenos días a todas y a todas. Decía que, bueno, vamos a empezar este seminario sobre arte, memoria y espacio público, tema en el que el museo ya lleva algunos años trabajando, ¿eh? Y como vamos a estar pocos, vamos a intentar adecuarnos lo más posible al tema de los idiomas, teniendo en cuenta que al final no vamos a tener traducción, pero nosotros somos políglotas, entonces nos arreglaremos. Lo primero que voy a hacer es una breve presentación del museo para que entendáis un poco, y igual atrasaremos un poquito el comienzo de Horst y de Andreas para dejar que la otra gente que falta que llegue, ¿de acuerdo? I was mentioning that it's a pleasure that you are here. We are going to start our seminar on art, memory and public space. This is an issue that we have worked the last years and as we are going to be in a small group, smaller than we thought because of many other reasons that we didn't know that some people couldn't come at the last moment, we will try to do the best on talking about languages. All of the team working for languages, so we try to do the best, okay? So thank you for your comprehension. The first thing that I am going to do is to introduce a little bit the museum. So we will let some time, and even if we start the first presentation a little bit later, we will have time for everything, don't worry. So letting the other people to arrive, okay? And like this I will do a presentation for you to know a little bit more about the museum. Ça va? Bueno, aquí os voy a hacer un breve repaso. You will have the things in English too, okay? Os voy a hacer un breve repaso un poco del trabajo del museo y un poco del trabajo de la destrucción de Guernica hasta la reconstrucción después de la guerra, para que veáis un poco. Bueno, aquí tenemos algunas fotos de Guernica antes del bombardeo. Y doy aquí, en el que podemos ver un poco cómo era la ciudad antes del bombardeo. Durante los momentos del bombardeo tendría unos 6.000, 7.000 habitantes, ¿no? En el momento de la guerra, incrementado por refugiados y gudaris que estaban en la zona. Bueno, aquí simplemente mencionar que para los que no sois de aquí, ¿no?, Guernica es y ha sido siempre una ciudad muy simbólica para los vascos, ¿no? Lugar de reunión, lugar de la casa de juntas, y también esa es una de las razones para que, atacando el corazón de Euskadi, ¿no?, desmoralizar un poco a la población y destruirlo. La Guerra Civil Española, que empieza en el 36 y termina en el 39, y que en el 37 se centra en la campaña del norte, donde el general Mola lanza una amenaza diciendo que si el norte no se rinde, destruirá todo el norte, y de esa amenaza es el bombardeo de Durango el 31 de marzo del 37 y el 26 de abril del 37 el bombardeo de Guernica. Sobre las 4 y cuarto de la tarde empiezan a llegar aviones. El bombardeo de Guernica fue realizado por la Legión Cóndor alemana, la Aviación Legionaria italiana, y tuvo una duración de más de 3 horas, con numerosos fallecidos y mucha gente que intentaba huir. Bueno, aquí tenemos un plano de Guernica, como más del 85% de la ciudad queda completamente arrasado. Y fábricas de armas, el árbol de Guernica y la casa de juntas y algún otro sitio, y el puente de Rentería, ¿no?, no queda destruido, pero lo que es la ciudad en sí, el pueblo en sí, la villa en sí, queda completamente arrasado. Aquí tenemos, bueno, una imagen del Guernica post bombardeo, por desgracia hoy en día estas imágenes son tan habituales en tantos sitios, ¿no?, que ya ni nos chocan, ¿no? Pero sobre las víctimas, sobre el número de muertos, hay mucha ha habido siempre mucha controversia, desde 2 personas hasta 12, hasta 200 con nombre y apellido, y hoy en día, bueno, las últimas investigaciones hablan pues de una cifra más parecida a la que el gobierno vasco dio en aquel momento, que hubieran sido unos 1.654 víctimas mortales. Muchas de ellas quedaron bajo los edificios, entre los escombros. Bueno, estas algunas fotos. Franco nunca aceptó que había sido un bombardeo, sino que había sido un incendio de los rojos separatistas en su huida del frente, que destruyeron y quemaron Guernica. Por eso, 3 días después, el 29 de abril, el Frente Nacional, los alemanes, los italianos y los marroquíes, junto a los requetés o carlistas, entran en Guernica. Guernica se cierra y se tapan los agujeros de las bombas, se ponen algunos bidones de gasolina y se trae a la gente para que demuestre que ha sido un incendio y no un bombardeo. Pero George Stier, uno de los corresponsales de guerra, que ese mismo día, por la tarde-noche, pudo venir a Guernica y al día siguiente, y pudo ver lo que había ocurrido. Aquí tenemos algunas de las fotos de Guernica en ruinas, y cómo el 85% de la ciudad queda completamente arrasada. Algunas de las fotos de cómo empiezan a limpiar la ciudad, y de hecho hubo hasta turistas que venían a ver la ciudad destruida en los meses posteriores a la destrucción. Aquí tenemos algunas de las fichas de regiones devastadas que se encargaría de hacer la reconstrucción de Guernica. El 12 de octubre del 39, Guernica se acoge a la ley de adopción, por la cual Franco es nombrado hijo adoptivo, y comienzan las labores, como en otros 102 pueblos, de reconstrucción. Desde el primer momento, el Frente Nacional y los franquistas marcan, ¿no?, y dejan claro que Guernica ha sido un incendio, y hablan un poco de esa propaganda. Aquí tenemos algunas imágenes de la reconstrucción. La reconstrucción fue realizada por prisioneros republicanos en trabajos forzosos, ¿no? La hizo en la parte central de la reconstrucción de aquí, del centro de Guernica, fue diseñada por el arquitecto Manuel María Smith. Y aquí tenemos algunas de las fotos de cómo se va reconstruyendo el ayuntamiento y algunos edificios del centro. The Town Hall, the City Council, where we are here, donde estamos ahora. El mercado se inaugura en 1943 y la plaza donde está el museo se inaugura en 1954. Hubo algunos lugares en Guernica que no se volvieron a reconstruir y que se perdieron un poco en la historia de la ciudad, ¿no?, como el frontón y la iglesia de San Juan, que no se volvieron a reconstruir. Y hay otros lugares que se han convertido un poco en patrimonio de ese momento de guerra, como son los refugios de Astra, de la fábrica de armas Astra, y lo que fue la fábrica de armas Astra, que hoy en día es un centro cultural gestionado por los jóvenes del pueblo. Aquí tenemos un poco cómo se ha seguido manteniendo viva la historia de Guernica y cómo generalmente es en los aniversarios, el 26 de abril, cuando se hacen grandes actos, los gobernantes y mucha otra gente, los supervivientes se acercan al cementerio de Zalló en Guernica a recordar lo ocurrido. Bueno, esto es un poco el museo, súper rápidamente. Se funda en 1998 por el ayuntamiento, hace 20 años, y desde el 2002 es una fundación.
If you don't mind, como está en castellano, lo voy a decir en inglés ahora, ¿vale? Para que todo el mundo... The museum was founded in 1998, 20 years ago, by the city council. It was a small museum. And then in 2002 it became a foundation in which not only the city council is, but the Basque government and the regional government of Vizcaya. And from 2002 it was decided that it was not going to be only a museum that talks about war, but talks about peace and human rights. So our working issue is peace and human rights and memory and history. This is for you. So all the permanent exhibition of the museum nowadays is going to be changed soon, I think in 1 year or a year and a half. But nowadays talks or wants to make think the visitor about three questions. What is peace? So making an introduction to the definition of peace and with things peace can be related. What happens in Guernica during the moment of lack of peace during the Spanish Civil War and the bombing of Guernica, with an audiovisual that recreates a house of Guernica, Begoña's house, that is a quite moving audiovisual that for many people is very shocking. And what happens with peace and human rights nowadays in the war, using Picasso's Guernica, a copy of Picasso's Guernica, and talking the last one about the Basque conflict. Or the recent memory of in the Basque country. Apart from that, we have a documentation center focused on the Spanish Civil War and the exile, with many books and many documents of archive, and that makes the possibility to many researchers to come here to do research. We have an educational department. Idoia, my colleague, is the head of the educational department, and we do many things with kids, with families. We go to the schools come to the museum, so we try to be very active. I didn't mention that we are only 7-8 women working here, so it's a small team. We try to be active, very active, but we are a small team. Here, it is another project that we did, Kids Guernica project. It was a project that was created in 1995 in Japan, to remember what happens with Picasso's Guernica, and it's been all around the world with many kids' Guernicas, all on the same size of Picasso's Guernica. Perhaps you notice that we have one big kids' Guernica on the entrance of the museum, on the facade of the entrance of the museum. Apart from that, all our temporary exhibitions try to work on those things: history and memory, peace and human rights. Nowadays we have the exhibition that we will visit later of made with Jesus Alonso about the monuments of victims of civil war and Franco times, and that's why we are going to do tomorrow the memory tour to visit those monuments in Gipuzkoa. Apart from that, we organize quite a lot of international and national seminars. Last year we organized this one about the reconstruction of the heritage after the war, with many people coming from different places. Here you have the books that we have. Here we have two more books that they are not here, the one of Jesus and another one. No, this is our collection on history and memory. Apart from that, we try to participate on European projects. For example, we participate in 2000 that. The situation has changed a lot because of the memory boom in Spain, in a project that it was called Paths of Memory, and it was a project that wanted to make like a tour, historical and touristical tour on the First World War, Second World War and Spanish Civil War, visiting some places. And for that project we organized doing everything about the Spanish Civil War, and it was very difficult at that moment to find people in the different places that work on those issues, because there were a lot of silence, no many associations. Then after this it was like a boom, and nowadays if we would do the same, that would be completely, completely different. Apart from that, we try to encourage young people to participate in other projects, and this was a project that we did with the Basque Television, and it was to try to, during the 26 April in the 70th anniversary of the bombing, to imagine what was the conversations among the protagonists of that moment via Twitter. So we create some protagonists and we did that via Twitter, and it was a test, a pilot thing, but it worked. Here you have some of our monuments that perhaps then later on we will have some time to visit some of them that remember that has that heritage of Guernica. Eh? We have the monument of Néstor Basterrechea, Agony of the Fire, the last one that has been presented, Eduardo Chillida's Gureitaren Etxea, Our Father House, Henry Mort, Large Figure in a Shelter, John Iturrarte, Marimeta, Jesús Aldama in the memory of the death of the bombing of Guernica. And I mentioned here too another artist from New York that has worked too about the memory of Guernica and the survivors and has done some presentations in New York in other places, that is Anita Gresta. Apart from that, we every 2 years with Maria from Guernica Gogoratuz Peace Research Center and with Ricardo from the Culture House, we organize seminars on art and peace and focus on different issues on art and peace. We have done several. The last one, for example, it was focused on memory and a public space in the urban area. We work with some artists that work outside doing graffitis and not only graffitis, and we brought here too some colleagues from the Medellin, from the Comuna 13, that they are doing very interesting projects for the communities. And one is, for example, a project that is called Cuerpos Gramaticales, Grammatical Bodies, in which they are like, how to say, they are like seeds that put on the ground people to remember and to make think the other people of what happened on those places. In 2016, that it was the big cultural San Sebastian was a big capital of for culture. We had a long program, more than 12 different activities each month, a seminar, and an exhibition, and a book. It was called La Embarcada Artivista, the Artivist Sailing, yes, because we work too a lot saying that we are not activists, but artivists. Apart from that, there have been some very interesting performances done by different artists here in Guernica. These first ones were done by an Australian artist that has worked a lot with us, William Kelly, and create this shape of like a laburu, like the sun in the Basque Country, with candles, and many survivors, many youngsters, and many people from Guernica participate on it, and we kept that performance for all the night, and it was a very moving thing. Then in 2004 we have like another collective from Chile, Colectivo Casa Grande, that did a bombing of poems in Guernica in August, and when there was the festivals here in Guernica, so it was important to, you know, they throw poems from a helicopter, and it was another way of bombing the city, you know, that was very moving for the population. This is another installation of Bill Kelly, and this is what I mentioned, the thing that we, the last performance that we did, that it was called Grammatical Bodies in last October. We try to work to not only in past history, but in recent history too, and we have some memory laboratories on the Basque conflict. So we try to join 20, 25 people of different political points of view and work together about our past, about our present together, etc. And here you have a mention of the importance of the website and the social network, but it is quite complicated being so little and in four languages doing everything, but we try the best to be in Facebook, in Twitter, in YouTube, in issue, in blog, blah, 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 blah. for the museum always has been very, very much important to work in networks with other museums and with other professionals, not only looking to what happens to us, but what happens in other places. So we are part of several networks, like Museums of Memory of Victims of Public Crimes, ICMEMO, the International Network of Museums for Peace, the International Coalition of Sites of Conscience, Euroclio of History Teachers, and the Forum of Associations of Peace and Human Rights Education here in the Basque Country. And that's a little bit, to know you a little bit who we are and what we do. Thank you. And now...